हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस बिगिन विथ ज्योग्राफी लेसन नंबर 3, प्लैनेटरी मोशंस, रोटेशन एंड रेवोल्यूशन। आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक्स, दैट इज पेज 133। लेट अस स्टार्ट द लेसन। एज यू सी पेज 133, देर इज अ गेयर अप बॉक्स ओवर देर एंड द फोटो ऑफ द ग्लोब इज गिवन। वॉट इज आस्क्ड हियर, वन एक्टिविटी इज देयर, draw an arrow to show the direction in which the earth revolves around the sun. So here you have to just show an arrow how the earth revolves around the sun, that is from west to east. It revolves from west to east. Now draw the axis of the earth while the angle of inclination in degree. As I have explained you earlier lesson, in the second lesson, that the angle of inclination is tilted. It is 66.5 degree tilt, and so it is little in slanting position, so earth never moves straight. You can see the position of the globe here, it is in a slanting manner. So here you have to just draw. It is an activity, children. If you do, it's okay. If you don't do, it's also okay. Here I will just like to explain that in the previous chapter we have learnt about the angle of inclination, that is the axis of the earth on which the earth rotates itself is from west to east, and the axis of the earth is inclined, that is about 66.5 degree. Okay students, now what we are going to study in this lesson, the topics included are rotation, circle of illumination, revolution, solstices and equinoxes. So these are the topics covered in this lesson. Let us first understand about what we observe daily, that is about the sunrise. See, this is a daily phenomenon, children. Whether it is holiday or not, whether it is any day, the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. This you have studied right from the nursery period, that the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. So this we have observed every day, children. And also sometimes it is our illusion. We feel that whenever we are traveling by car or whenever we are traveling by road, we see that the tree is moving backward, children. So students, why it happens that when we are moving ahead in train or car, the trees and the houses appear to move backward? This is because our earth is in constant motion, children. So whenever we are moving fast, then the kilometers of the earth, we feel that everything is going backwards. This is our illusion. It's not happening actually, but it's our illusion. So the earth is a planet. It moves around the sun. You understand this, children? Sun is not moving from east to west. We have studied in the nursery section that sun rises in the east and sets in the west. So you must be imagining that time that sun is coming from this side and going towards that side. No, sun is at that place only. The earth is moving around the sun. So all the planets, not only the sun, all the planets have two motions. Remember, children, all the planets have two motions. Here it is written, rotation and revolution. Rotation and revolution, children. All planets moves around itself, that is they move around its own axis, that is called rotation. And when the planets, always they move around the sun, but their path is fixed, that is called that elliptical orbit, that is fixed. So that is called as what? That motion is called revolution. And what about the spin on the tilted axis from west to east? Except Venus. See, Venus is little different. It moves from east to west. So they will appear from there. Venus, it will appear that the sun rises in the west and sets in the east from Venus, children. But other planets except Venus all move from west to east, and that is why we see the sun appearing to rise from the east and set in the west. And when the planets move, they have their own fixed path. They move in one elliptical orbit, and the speed of the movement depends upon how the planet is close to the sun. So accordingly, children, now we move on to page 134, that as Mercury is the closest planet to the sun, it will take only 88 days to move around the sun, whereas Neptune being the farthest, it takes about 165 Earth years. Now, what is this Earth years, children? That Earth year is of 365 days. But Neptune's movement, as it is the last planet from the sun, so it takes about 165 Earth years, means 165 multiplied by 365 days. That much time Neptune takes to move around the sun. And you know, what about Earth? It takes 1 year. Means 1 year means what? 365 days to move around the sun. Now we start with our first topic, that is the rotation. So what do you mean by rotation? The spinning of the earth around its imaginary line of axis is known as rotation. So when the earth moves around its own self and it moves on its axis, children, and I told you the axis of the earth is tilted, so it keeps a little slanting position of the earth, and the earth is little slanted and it moves around itself, and it takes 24 hours to complete one rotation, that is equal to 1 day, children. So this is because of the rotation only we experience day and night. So when we are facing the sun, that time of the earth, wherever we are, that will experience the daylight, that is the sunlight, and that is the daytime. Whereas the other part of the earth, which is on the opposite side of the sun, will be having night time. For example, that now, for example, you are listening in the morning, and then America, USA will be having night. And when USA is having daytime, that time will be experiencing the night time, children. So, the as studied in the previous chapter, the axis of the earth is inclined at an angle of 23.5 degrees from the plane of elliptic. When we see the plane of ecliptic, that is 23.5 degrees. But we say that it is 66.5 degrees to its orbital plane. The earth axis is tilted at an angle of 66.5 degrees to its orbital plane. This is known as inclination of the earth's axis. Inclination matlab thoda teda, tilted. How much degree? 66.5 degrees. This I have explained to you in the previous chapter also. And those, see children here, effects of rotation is what? First, the main effect is, it causes day and night. Otherwise, if there was no rotation, then we'll be experiencing full time daylight. The portion which is facing the sun will have daytime every time, and the portion which is opposite to the sun will have night time, children. So because of this rotation, every day we have day and night. Here on page 134, we have info paper box. Here it is told about Nicholas Copernicus, and he was a Polish astronomer who said that it is not the sun but actually the earth that moves around the sun. So he was the first as person, he was the first scientist to believe that and to explain that sun is not moving but actually the earth is moving around the sun. Now the second information, whose picture it is? Sir Isaac Newton. He propagated the theory of planetary movements. He explained that two motions of all the planets, that is rotation and revolution, through his three laws of motion, we can conclude that planets are whirling bodies. Whirling means movement, continuously in movement, they are moving only. Then movement means on its own they are moving continuously. Whirl, whirl means movement. And planets move around the sun on an orbital plane. So all planets move around the sun on a fixed path, that is called as what? Orbital plane. And their speed remains constant. Aisa nahi ki kabhi zyada tez speed mein bhag rahe, fir slow rahe. No, the speed is the same. That is why we don't feel the movement of the earth or planets. Because if they're taking high speed, chalo abhi raat ka time hai to chalo speed bada do. No. So the speed is, children, constant. That is why we don't feel the motion of the planet Earth. And here one extra information is also that there they move in the same direction. They don't change the direction, children. If the Earth is moving from west to east, then it will go only in west to east, and the speed is also constant. This was proved by Sir Isaac Newton, and about the planetary motions. Okay, children. Now one on this page 134, there is a difference between inclination and axial tilt, children. So I'll just read out that it is better known as angle of inclination or incidence to the ecliptic. It is known as the tilt of the axis. It is the angle between the orbital plane and the Earth's axis, which is 66.5 degrees. It is the angle between the rotational axis and a line perpendicular to its orbital plane, which is 23.5 degrees. See, children, this you will understand properly. I'll just tell you that angle of inclination is known as what? It is incident to the ecliptic, on the motion which it is moving, elliptical orbit. And the axial tilt is in correspondence with the rotation movement, that is on the Earth latitude. The reference plane may change as the effect of the inclination goes on increasing towards the pole. So this line of axis is inclined towards the poles much, so the plane may change, and the fixed axis is always pointing towards the North Star. So this, when we talk about the straight, that is angle of inclination, or sorry, axial tilt, that time it is facing the North Star, that is the pole star, children. And one year info babble box is there. It is explaining you about axial tilt. Tilt is different from angle of inclination. It is the angle between a planet's rotational axis and a line perpendicular to its orbital plane. So this is different than the inclination axis, children. The equator of a rotating planet never appears to be parallel to its orbital plane. If the Earth's axis was perpendicular to the orbital plane, then not only the equator but also all the places on the Earth would have 12 hours of day and 12 hours of night. So if this inclination was not there, then there would be equal day and equal night. Means every day 6 o'clock there will be complete day, and evening 6 o'clock it will be complete dark. But it is not like that. Whenever the sun rises, it is not immediately that it becomes full lighted on full Earth. Equal, that is not there. There is a varying length of day and night. Sometimes the day is longer, you know, in summer season the day is longer and the nights are shorter. Whereas in the winter season we have experienced that the nights are longer and the days are shorter, children. So this is because of the tilt, axial tilt of the Earth. And if it was not tilted, then there will be 12 hours day and 12 hours night. So here, effects of the rotation on page 135, it is that day and nights happen on the Earth because of the rotation of the Earth. Always one half of the Earth gets illuminated and the other half is always in darkness. That I explained to you, that suppose we are experiencing day now in America, there will be night because half of the Earth, that is a front part of the Earth which is facing the sun, will have daytime and the other part will be having the night time. Dusk and dawn occur at the end circle of illumination. Now what is dusk and dawn? Dusk means just after the sunset. Just after the sunset, it will not be immediately dark, children. And just after the sunrise, it will not immediately be brightened. It slowly we move from dark to light and light to darkness, children. This I'll explain you in the circle of illumination. And the winds, ocean currents deflect after crossing the equator, means they change their direction after they cross the equator. The direction changes because of this rotation of the Earth, children. Now our next topic is circle of illumination, that is on page number 135. Here you can see the diagram. What is circle of illumination? You can see here, suppose the Earth's axis would not have been tilted, as I explained you on the earlier page, then there will be equal day and equal night, children. But you see, because the tilt is there, now it is tilted. So the, what we say, more than half will be facing what? Night here, and less than half will be having your daytime. So the phenomenon get reversed in the southern hemispheres. You can see here, children, the Earth's axis is little tilted. So instead of being half day and half night, more of the daytime, because it is tilted towards the sun now. Northern hemisphere is tilted towards the sun. So more than half of the time there is a daytime, and here it should be equally dark, but here it is more portion is in the darker side, children. You can see the diagram here. Again, I will explain you here. So 90 degree north, that is a north pole, and 90 degree south, also south pole, which is the circle of illumination, that half experiencing day and night equal. But because it is tilted and the north pole is inclined towards the sun, that is more than half is day, and here less than half is what? Night. Here you can see Tropic of Cancer, the equator, and the Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degree north, and equator 0 degree, and Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degree south. Again, I will read this. The earth is spherical in shape and completes one spin in 24 hours. I told you, one rotation gets completed in 24 hours. In this course, every portion of the earth that faces the sun, that receives the sunlight, and the part that directly opposite to the sun remains what? In darkness, whereas the facing the sun will have light, that is a daytime. The circle which divides the earth into light and dark halves is known as circle of illumination. The half, it divides the earth into two parts. Half, that is a lit portion, that is a lightened portion, and the half, that is a dark portion. It is because of this circle that we get different parts of the day and the night. But the circle of illumination slowly changes from the east to the west because the earth rotates from west to east. I explained you earlier that because it rotates from west to east, the circle of illumination goes from east to west. And this is because two phenomena occurs, varying lengths of day and nights. And this phenomenon gets reversed in the southern hemisphere. Suppose the northern hemisphere is inclined towards the sun, then the days are longer and the nights are shorter. Simultaneously, the phenomena gets reversed in the southern hemisphere when it is inclined towards the sun. Here now, the nights are longer and the days are shorter because it is inclined towards the northern hemisphere. The effect of inclination goes on increasing as we move towards the poles. There is longer duration of days or nights from 18 hours to 24 hours at higher altitude. Suppose we move towards the poles, that is why 6 months day and 6 months night, whenever the earth axis is inclined towards the northern hemisphere, then 6 months day in the north pole, 90 degree, and 6 months, that time 6 months night in the southern hemisphere. Similarly, when the southern hemisphere, that is the south pole, is inclined towards the sun, then what will happen here? More portion of the 24 hours, it will be what? Daytime, and 24 hours, it will be nighttime. 12 hours duration each. This is because the sun shines vertically at equator throughout the year. So, equator length of day and night are equal, children. But as we go towards the poles, that is, as we go upwards or as we go down from the equator, then the length and the day will have what we say varying length, means days and nights will not be equal. Sometimes there will be longer day and shorter nights. Sometimes there will be longer night and shorter days. But at equator, it will be equal. Equal days and equal night. See, the part of the day what is shown. Dawn means the early period of the day. Midday means what? The sun is seen overhead. It is in the pink box, page 135, children. Also called as a noontime. Dusk means the sun is now going to set, but it is not completely dark. Little darkness has come, but not completely dark. And night means completely dark. And midnight means the circle of illumination has moved to the exactly the opposite side. Now, the circle of illumination has come to the opposite side. That is called as the midnight. So, I hope you understood, children, till here. We have covered two main topics here. That is about the planetary motions, about rotation, and the second most important is circle of illumination, which causes unequal day and night, children. So, this is the first part of the chapter, geography, lesson number 3 we are doing, children, about rotation and revolution. And in this, we have completed two parts. Sorry, in this part, we have completed two topics, rotation and the circle of illumination. Kindly read page 133, 134 and 135. Also, you have to draw the diagram on page 135, children, circle of illumination. That diagram you have to draw, page 135. Listen to the video. You all are not going through the video also. Listen to through this video and understand the lesson. Just don't be after copying notes only. Only you want to copy notes. You have to complete your book, children. That is also important. But go through this YouTube videos. We have completed this topic. In the next part, I'll be concluding this same lesson. Okay, till then, thank you.